Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Zeke, Dogumentary TV, YouTube channel for dog lovers. If you guys have not already, please go ahead and subscribe to the channel. Also, please hit the like button, interact with the video as best you can, leave a comment. I look forward to hearing what you guys have to say. This is another one of my top 10 lists, which I don't think that everyone's going to agree with. Feel free to leave your comments, your critiques below the video. All right, guys, what I like to do when making these videos is give the parameters, things that I took into consideration when determining my top 10 dog breeds. Personal protection, it requires a different skill set than a home or a property protector. Personal protection dogs protect an individual or small group of people. These dogs go where their people go. That means these dogs will travel and will often have to engage with the public. This is basically a 24/7 job for the dog. The dog will work wherever dogs are allowed to be. Home, office, trips to the bank. Wherever dogs are allowed, the dog will be working. A good personal protector will have to have the sensibilities of a service animal along with the performance abilities of a police dog. All right, so let's get into the criteria that makes a dog breed a good personal protector. Starting with the protection skills, the breed must be able to defend its owner. In a dog's defense tool bag, audible and visual intimidation. Audibly, more points are given for an imposing bark. Visually, more points were given to the breeds that look more intimidating. Let's face it, a loud bark, an intimidating looking dog will deter 99% of all attackers. The next set of tools in the dog's protection bag are its active measures. What offensive skill does a dog have to beat back an attacker? Active measures are athleticism, strength, courage, and bite. The last set of tools that I will take into consideration will be the livability and mobility. If a dog is going to be your personal protector, that means that you will be spending a lot of time with him. How easy is this dog breed to live with? And the mobility, how easy is it to get this breed in and out of cars? How much time and consideration must be taken to comfortably travel with each breed? These are all very important questions. And let me just say right now, every dog on this list are excellent personal protectors. The reality of it will be which dog best suits your situation and your circumstances. All right, guys, let's get into my list. At number 10, I have the Brazilian Mastiff. This breed is known for its superb tracking ability, aggressiveness, and an unforgiving, impetuous temperament. The Fila is used as a guard dog, as a cattle dog for livestock, and as a hunting dog for tracking and controlling large game. The breed's personal protection strengths by far are its visual and audible deterrence. The breed has considerable active measures abilities as well. Strength and a man-stopping bite are the breed's best skills. Filas also score well in the livability. Like most Mastiff breeds, they are gentle and loving with their owners. The breed does have some weaknesses as well. They lack the speed and athleticism to quickly apprehend an attacker. I highly doubt the breed's ability to function in most public areas. Also, being a very large breed, they're not as easy to travel with. At number 9, I have the Boxer. The Boxer is a medium to large-sized dog, short-haired, developed in Germany. They were loyal, hard-working canines that were used as protectors, hunters, and even couriers. They were one of the first breeds deployed as police dogs in Germany. Boxers are excellent personal protectors. They are a great audible and visual deterrence. They are very athletic with good strength and a solid bite. They are also easy to transport and easy to live with. Number 8, the Rottweiler. This is one of the oldest herding breeds. The dogs are said to have been used by traveling butchers to drive cattle to market, protecting the cattle from robbers and wild animals. The butchers would also have the dogs guard the money pouches on their return trip back home. The breed's personal defensive strengths are a very considerable audible and visual deterrence. Their active measures are strength, courage, and a solid bite. Where this breed truly excels is in livability. Rottweilers are not as high energy as many of the other breeds on this list. The breed's weaknesses are they are below average athletically in comparison to most of the breeds on the list. Being one of the larger breeds on my list, their mobility score is below average as well. You would need a larger vehicle to travel comfortably with the Rottweiler as your protector. The same could be said for the Fila, if I didn't mention that. Number 7, the Cane Corso. The Italian Mastiff, originally bred as a farm dog, a Cane Corso were used to guard property, livestock, and families. Historically, it has been used by night watchmen, keepers, carters, and drovers. Cane Corso's personal protection strengths are its visual and audible deterrence. Additionally, the breed has exceptional strength, courage, and a man-stopping bite. For its size, the Cane Corso has great athleticism. In terms of the breed's weaknesses, they're really not that substantial. Breed size makes it not as easy as some of the other breeds on the list to travel with, but that is easily offset by the high score for livability. Some Cane Corsos can be heavy droolers. That would be the only downside to keeping a Cane Corso close to you. Number 6 on my list is the Giant Schnauzer. The Giant Schnauzer is a working breed of dog developed in the 17th century in Germany. The Giant Schnauzer was originally bred as a multi-purpose farm dog for guarding property and driving animals to market. Today, the Giant Schnauzer is used as a police dog. It's trained for obedience, dog agility, herding, search and rescue, and IPO. Giant Schnauzers are a well-rounded breed and are excellent personal protectors. The breed's deep chest produces a very imposing bark, and most large black dogs will provide ample visual deterrence. Additionally, the breed has exceptional athleticism, strength, and courage. The breed's size may be its only downside when it comes to personal protection. Transporting large dogs like this can be an issue and may not be suited for everyone's commute. In relation to other large dog breeds on the list, the Giant Schnauzer will be the most energetic. The number 5 dog on my list is the Beauceron. The Beauceron is a powerful French working dog, originally bred to serve as a living fence, herding dog, and flock guardian. In France, some police departments still use this breed as police dogs, as well as in search and rescue. The Beauceron is an excellent personal protector, providing ample, audible, and visual deterrence. The breed possesses all the athleticism, strength, and courage to take on any attacker. With males coming in at 71 to 99 pounds, the smaller Beauceron is a reasonable travel companion. Probably get them into a small sedan and travel comfortably. Like all the herding breeds you'll see on this list, energy management will be an issue with the Beauceron. At number 4, I have the Dutch Shepherd. The Dutch Shepherd is one of the European Shepherd breeds. Like other Shepherd breeds, the Dutch Shepherd is highly intelligent, very athletic, and a great working dog. They are an affectionate, steadfast, and loyal dog that form strong attachments with their family. With an appropriate introduction, they can live well with other dogs and children. This breed is perfectly suited for personal protection work. They have the ability to work close and at a distance from their person. The breed's only downsides may be livability. They are a high-energy breed that is constantly looking for something to do. Number 3 on my list is the Belgian Malinois. Belgian Malinois is one of 4 Belgian Shepherd breeds. Originally a sheepdog, today the Belgian Malinois is a breed of choice by most military and police departments worldwide. This breed is an excellent personal protector for the right person. The breed doesn't have the visual and audible deterrence factor of the larger Mastiff breeds on my list. They make up for it with their athleticism and courage. Very much the same dog as a Dutch Shepherd with a bit more size. The only drawback to this breed will be livability. These dogs can be neurotic and hard to live with if they don't get enough stimulus. Number 2 on my list is the Doberman Pinscher. The Doberman Pinscher is a German breed developed by Louis Doberman specifically for the purpose of personal protection. Needless to say, today's Doberman is an excellent personal protector. Dobermans are large and provide great audible and visual deterrence. The breed has exceptional athleticism and courage. Because they are smart and fast, they can work close and at a distance from their person. The breed is large, so transport could be an issue, but they are amazing companions and rank very high for me in terms of livability. Down to number 1, let me first say that there's very little distinction between breeds 4 to 1 as far as the quality of personal protection you're going to get from any of these dogs. Honestly, all 10 breeds on the list give you excellent personal protection. What it really will come down to is you, the person being protected, and figuring out which breed best suits your needs, personality, and circumstances. Okay guys, my number 1 dog breed for personal protection, the German Shepherd. Obviously, the breed originates in Germany, where it is originally used as a herding dog. Today, the German Shepherd is one of 2 breeds most often used in police and military applications around the world. The German Shepherd has all the visual and audible deterrence you could expect from a dog. Not only does it look and sound intimidating, The breed is highly recognizable and has a reputation that will have any would-be attacker second-guessing his next move. The breed is athletic with a good deal of size and strength. And when it comes to working line German Shepherds, courage is very seldom an issue. So in terms of negatives with this breed, relative to this list, the breed is one of the larger dogs. With that being said, transport may be an issue. You may have to make some accommodations to travel with the German Shepherd. That would be a small price to pay for the quality of personal protection you will get with this dog breed. So there you guys have it, my top 10 list. The German Shepherd is number one for a lot of reasons. It is a great combination of size, strength, courage, intelligence, athleticism, mixed with the livability. I think most people do not take into consideration livability. A dog doing personal protection, you would probably want to be really integrated into your life. So a dog that when you're at the office, it can sit quietly next to you. When you're in the car, it can sit in the back seat. These are qualities that you will appreciate in your personal protector. All right, guys, if you guys have any questions, comments, or suggestions, feel free to leave them. And I'll talk to you guys on the next one, all right? Peace.